What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo. And yes, we're continuing our SCCM setup within our Proxmox lab. Well, within my Proxmox lab. And today is all about deploying Windows 11 23H2. So let's get right into it. All right, so you're probably saying to yourself, Bernardo, why are you deploying Windows 11 23H2 if 24H2 is out? Well, 24H2 for me, it's not really stable as of yet. 23H2 stable. So that's the reason why I'm pushing it out. So let's get into our SCCM server. And this is my SCCM server within my Proxmox lab. And the first thing that I am going to do is open up the File Explorer. Within here, I'm going to select the D drive. I'm going to go into the D drive and I'm going to create a new folder and I'm going to call it sources. Now, this sources folder is where I'm going to drop the operating system files into, as well as create packages and all that other good stuff goes into the sources folder. I'm going to right click on the folder. I'm going to go to properties. I'm going to go to sharing. I'm going to click on advanced sharing. I'm going to check off share this folder. I'm going to give a dollar sign to the shared name because it is going to hide it. I'm going to go to permissions and I'm going to give it full control. I'm going to click on apply and then click OK. Click apply again, click OK, and then close it. I already mounted the Windows 11 ISO image within my SCCM server. So I'm going to open up the source folder as well as the image side by side, and I'm just going to select all the files and then move them over into the source folder. Now, behind the scenes, I did a little bit of cleanup. I think I created a folder called Windows 11 version 23H2, and then I dropped the files that I placed inside the root of the source folder. It's not best practice to do that. Keep it nice and clean. Once you drag and drop everything into the source folder, it's going to start copying and you're done. Again, like I said, behind the scenes, I clean this up because this is not the way to do it. I don't like this way. It's bothering me just looking at it right now. So once you have your operating system files already copied over to your sources folder, or if you have something else and it's copied over, let's open up the configuration manager console. Awesome. Now from here, we're going to go into software. Within software, we're going to go into operating systems. Within here, let's select operating system images. Let's right click on it. And let's click on add operating system image. Now click on browse. And for the file name, I am going to enter the UNC path of that sources folder that I created with you guys with the dollar sign, because again, it's hidden. We're going to click on open. And like I said before, I cleaned it up behind the scenes and I created a folder called Windows 11 version 23H2. So I'm going to double click on the folder. We're going to go into sources, and within sources, we're going to select the install.win file. We're going to click on open. Awesome. Now I'm going to check off by checking the box, you are agreeing that when applying the image to a device, either blah, blah, blah. So check that off. The next thing that I'm going to check off is extract the specific image index from the specific WIN file. So check that off. I'm going to click on the drop-down menu and I am going to pick number 3. Okay, we're going to click on next. We're going to click on the language drop-down menu and then pick your language. I'm going to pick English. Pick your flavor. I'm going to do X64 and then click on next. Provide a name. I provided the following. You are able to provide a version in the comment. It is up to you. Once you enter all that information, just click on next. A nice little summary. Click on next. It's going to start importing the operating system into your configuration manager. Once it's done, you get a green check mark, which is good, and we are going to close it. There goes our operating system. Once you're here, we're going to right click on our operating system and we're going to select update distribution points. Click next here, click on the add, pick on distribution points, select your DP, click OK, click next, green check mark, which is always a good thing, and then click on close. Give it some time. This needs to process behind the scenes. So eventually what's going to happen at the right side at the content status, it should change to in progress. And then if you give it some more time, it should change to success, green. Once it's green, next thing that we need to do is create a task sequence. So let's head over to task sequences. Let's right click on it and select create task sequence. We're going to leave it as the default, install an existing image package. So click on next, give your task sequence a name, click on browse, and then select your boot image, and then click okay. We're going to click next here. Now for the image package, we're going to click on browse, and we only have one. That is the one that we imported into the operating system images node. So we're going to select it and then click on okay. Now, the only thing that I checked off from here is configure task sequence for use with BitLocker. So I unchecked that. For product key, I left it as blank because I actually have a key management server running within my environment to license all these workstations. Now, before we click on next, I am going to enable the local admin and provide a password and then confirm it and then click on next. Now, from here, you're able to join a work group or a domain. I am going to select join a domain. I'm going to click on browse and I'm going to select my domain and then click OK. For the domain OU, I am going to click on browse. I'm going to open up the BTNHD OU and I'm going to select workstations and I'm going to click OK. Now, we need to set an account. So let's click on set, give the username, give it the password, confirm the password. Click on verify, click on test connection, click OK, and then click on next. For the configuration manager client, I left it as a default, click next here. For the configure the state migration, I unchecked all this and I clicked on next. For updates, I left it as do not install any software updates and I clicked on next. For applications, I did not add any packages, so I clicked next here, a nice little summary, and then click on finish. Awesome. All green check mark, which is always a good thing. And then we need to close it. So once our task sequence is created, we are going to right click on it and we need to select distribute content. From here, we're going to click on next and next again. Let's click on add and we're going to pick distribution point. Click on your DP, click on okay, click next, a nice little summary, click next and a green check mark and then close it. Now we just distribute our task sequence, so it's time for us to deploy it. Now to deploy it, let's right click on it and then select deploy. For the collection, let's click on browse. You're going to get this warning, click okay. And I'm going to select all unknown computers and then click okay. Let's click on next. For make available to the following, I am going to click on the drop-down menu and I'm going to select only media and Pixie and then click next here. For scheduling, I didn't do anything, click next. For the user experience, left it as a default, so click next here. For alerts, I didn't do anything, click next. For the distribution point, I checked both options and then I click next here. A nice little summary and then click next and then green check mark, which is always a good thing. And let's click on close. And that's it, guys. That is how we import an operating system and also create a task sequence. I think on the later videos, I'm going to show you guys a demo of deploying it. Plus, I had some issues with deploying, and I'm going to show you how I fixed that. And that's it. Hopefully, you guys enjoy, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.